Well, on Friday, we wore our heart on our sleeve, showering those we love with a little extra attention for Valentine's Day. And today we're talking about another important matter of the heart, as February is Heart Month. Chad and Misty Hurston's daughter, Rayleigh, was treated at Norton Children's Hospital for her congenital heart defect. They are what we call a brave heart family. Dana Matukas is here from Norton Children's Hospital. So let's talk about our brave heart families and who they are.
So our brave hearts, it's a support group of families united by their children's fight for life after they've been diagnosed with a heart condition that requires surgery. So many times they've endured multiple heart surgeries, heart transplant, and an array of related medical procedures. So our Brave Hearts chapter here in Bowling Green started 5 years ago and is an extension of our Louisville chapter. It's part of Norton Children's Hospital and Norton Children's Heart Institute, affiliated with the University of Louisville School of Medicine. So the Brave Hearts, it's about the support, but also bringing awareness to our community and also raising funds for the future of heart care.
Right, and you had a big name there, a Louisville native who made it big in Hollywood, Jennifer Lawrence. Yes. She gave a significant amount of money to the hospital.
That's right. We opened our new Jennifer Lawrence cardiac intensive care unit last month. So patients were moving in, tears were flowing. It was definitely a moment for not only the staff, but all the donors that have supported Heart along the way and have been there. So it is a 17 private room unit, and it also has just advanced technology, top of the line, but having those private rooms for our families to recover together and allowing not only the patient, but the parents and any siblings to be there.
Right. Misty, I'm sure you and Chad can attest to that. I mean, so let's talk about Rayleigh's heart journey.
Yeah, so Rayleigh was born in December of 2012. Shortly after being born here in Bowling Green, she was life-flighted out to Norton Children's Hospital in Louisville. She had her first open heart surgery at 6 days old. She had her first stent at 2 years old. She had her stent expanded when she was 4, and then when she was almost 5, she went through 3 open heart surgeries within 2 weeks of each other. So she has had a rough go, but is doing wonderful today, and she will continue to have other surgeries as she grows, because she will outgrow the pieces that have been added in.
This is a tough little girl right here.
Very tough.
Chad, that had to be so hard. You have your brand new daughter, you're overcome with joy, but then you learn she's sick, and to see her be life-flighted to Louisville, I mean, that had to be really scary for you.
That is, yeah. We went through, you can't tell it today by looking at her, but we've been through some tough times. And, you know, we're here today, still as a family. Me and Misty both are proud parents today and still have a beautiful daughter. Yeah. For one reason only, and that's because God heard and answered prayers and worked through Norton's Children's Hospital.
And you see that precious little baby in that picture, and I can just only imagine, you know, the fear that you felt.
Yeah.
Hoping her life would be saved, and it was. Look at this beautiful family photo. Rayleigh, what's your dog's name?
Baca.
Baca?
Baca, it's German.
I like that, because that's a German Shepherd, right?
Yes.
So that's perfect. Gorgeous family photos. And look at you, Miss Princess, with boxing gloves.
Yeah.
You like to box? Don't mess with
Rayleigh. I'm a heart warrior.
I like that.
Yeah.
How old are you, Rayleigh?
7
years old, and where do you go to school?
Austin Tracy.
Austin Tracy. What kinds of things do you like to do?
Spend time with my family, play with my dogs, and ride my four-wheeler.
Oh, fun. Misty, what would you like to say to other families that this might be down the road for them, that their child is born with a congenital heart defect? It's pretty common, really.
It is.
What kind of hope do you want to give them?
As far as Norton's Children's Hospital goes, they've offered us a lot of support in a lot of areas. You know, which we've been there for going on be 7 years, what was 7 years this past year. And Dr. Wright has almost become like family to us, where we see her once a year. And we were even talking on the way over here about Rayleigh's last surgeries. Of course, she had the 3 within 2 weeks of each other. And so she did have some complications. And I was scared to leave the room. Her dad was there. Her parents were there. But I was scared to leave the room even to go take a shower. And Dr. Wright found out, and she came in and offered at the end of her shift just to come sit with Rayleigh so that I knew she was okay, just long enough for me to go take a shower. And it's little things like that. You know, there's a lot of hospitals you can consider. But when you look at the care and the extra mile that some of these doctors and nurses will go, it means a lot to the families when you're going through that.
Well, thank you all for sharing your story, Rayleigh. We're glad that you're feeling good. You're healthy. Do you got to go back to school this afternoon?
Tomorrow.
Okay. Well, we're glad that you were able to be here with us. Thank you to
the
Harston family.
Thank you for having us.
You're very welcome. And you, Dana, as always, February is Heart Month. To learn more about pediatric heart care at Norton Children's Hospital and supporting families like the Harstons, you can go online, nortonchildrens.com/bravehearts.